Mike Tyson is an awesome prospect. A prospect in the process of becoming a fighter, a challenger, a champion. All in the next week and a half when he's going to fight 10 times. Just kidding, folks. But it does seem that already, prematurely, he's being treated like some sort of human trash compactor, expected to go out there and just grind everyone into powder. And if he does anything less, it's failure. So let's just remember that even the best prize fighters let some opponents standing and the critics clucking. And that he is just 19 and that he's been a professional only for 14 months. And he still has much to prove. That his punch will do as much damage to the better class of fighters as it did to the less better class of fighter. That he'll be able to take a punch. That he'll fight back when he's hurt. That he'll persist when he's frustrated. That he'll be able to go 10 hard rounds. And most importantly, that he'll be able to deal with stardom. Not let it suffocate him. Let it inspire him. So that he can shoulder the burden of other people's expectations. His expectation tonight is to beat Mitchell Green. But Mitchell Green, like him, is off the streets of New York, not Mr. Rogers' neighborhood. Not no boom.
Say one of the kids got killed or was in jail or whatever. Time I fought, I would stop until I did make a guy bleed. You see what I'm saying? Those times I had fights, the guys would grab me and try to break it out. Let me go. And I wouldn't be satisfied if I see a little scratch or a little blood here, a little blood there, you know.
But Mitch stayed very well for a little longer. He didn't really change until he became a boxer. And that changed him. I guess this way he could let off some of his frustrations and anger. And I don't know, he just had a mean streak. But yet, he was good to people. He would help people. And in the home, very respectful, very obedient. You wouldn't believe the things he would do in the street, because in the home, he was so different.
If you play by the rules, you can hit people legally in the ring. He won four Golden Gloves titles. Be professional.
fights is that sometimes you have to jump up and down and shout and watch fights to get what you want. We paid an unscheduled visit to a Don King press conference to demand what he felt he should get.
I got all the potential in the world to be a great fighter, okay? But I ain't got championship mentality. You see what I'm saying? Now, if I said, okay, do me as you wish, I get a title shot. I'll be broke, but I'll be a champ. Who wanna come home broke with a belt?
And if he has to fight Mike Tyson to get a shot, okay. Even if friends think that's going too far.
Buddy. Huh? I don't think you can mess with Tyson.
What are you going to do when somebody hit him and we hit a guy and the guy don't move?
You can't mess with Mike Tyson, right? Not do it.
Mitchell Green has taken up Mike Tyson's on the streets all his life.
Tyson, I ask for you, I'm going to break your neck. You can't fool me. Look at me good, like I told you before. This is Blood Mitchell Green. The one all the fools was done, man. I haven't had a chance to fight. And I was losing my desire for this fight. Before the fight game until you stepped in my life.
Well, Charlene Green, ringside, very nervous lady. We spoke with her yesterday. She, of course, as we mentioned, has really been very much of a stabilizing factor in the life of her son, Mitch Blood Green. She hates that nickname. She said so in that piece. And it's been a fight that Mitchell Green seems to have been fighting for the better part of this week. We talked in that piece a little bit earlier about his jumping up and down and shouting. Well, that's exactly what he had to do at a press conference, or rather at a weigh-in yesterday.
I never dunked nobody.
Well, he said that he doesn't have a championship mentality. And here's another example of it. At the weigh-in, he raised the ruckus, tried to extort more money from his manager, Carl King.
And I mean that.
He knew what he was supposed to get, but just thought he might get a little bit more if he raised a little heck.
And Mitchell Green now making his way down the hallway, and it's a very short walk up to the ring here. Should point out one other thing, too. There was a story released a little bit earlier today by the New York Post and spoken about on some of the local television newscasts here in New York as well, that the New York Police Department would perhaps arrest Mitchell Green either before or after the fight. Well, the story is there is a minor warrant for harassment that was issued on May 13th for Mitchell Green. The official statement of the police department says it's a violation, it's not a crime, and after the fight, Green's agent will be informed of exactly what action the police department will take, and it could be an arrest, it could be a fine, nobody really knows, but that is the official word. In the meantime, Mitchell Green has some business to take care of. Here's a look at the record of Mitch Green, the one loss to Trevor Burbick, the draw early in his career, 10 knockouts.
We saw him as far back as his amateur career. He was always a very spirited, very tough kid in the ring. Not a classic style, but he'd fight you.
And he's made no bones about the fact he wants to get in there and go dukes with Mike Tyson. Of course, the question is,